Tree banned out of fourth pick.
So much pushing power if they do offer the Ash Karma here. This lane was a terror to play against in 7-4. We'll see if that remains the case in 7-5. But Unicorns of Love really need to round out this composition with something strong, because right now, pressure on the bot lane.
And they're full on the early game so right now, so I think it almost has to be the Thresh. Maybe a Bard if you want to lose gracefully and make picks. Even then, you're playing against quite a few champions with mobility. A bit harder to lock down.
Bard getting locked in.
It's the safer choice. Because if you play the lane as Thresh versus Karma, Ashe, you walk up, you see the montage, you hook, they sidestep, the lane's over. At that point, you've lost. Because you get like a volley in your face, Mantra Q, W, the AD carry gets shield, and you now lost two potions, and you're getting pushed in over and over and over. So the Bard is a lot safer. Unicorn's comp here, it screams picks all around.
Well, we've seen in the past, too, Caitlyn Bard has been such a good setup coming at the Unicorn to love. They love the alt into the trap, into the wall stun. So if they can catch anyone out, they are doomed, even just from those two picks. It's looks strong, but I mean, is it all in the early game? Is there any late game
scaling? I mean, late game scaling for Renekton really isn't the greatest. Yes, he is playing not really versus any tanks. So in that sense, it's okay-ish. But yeah, all these champions scale rather poorly. H2K, I think, have a better late game. So they'll definitely need to survive the early pick attempts that the Unicorns will be firing at them. And I'm definitely keeping my eyes on Hillisang, on Xerxe, what's going to happen on the map if they roam together, if they combine those ultimates.
Have to see how they utilize these tools, how they adjust in this game, because H2K kind of going to be on the back foot from the early game in terms of raw champion power. See what they can do as a team, as a squad.
Yeah, definitely so.
Well, the battle for dominance in Group B is about to begin with Game 1 between H2K and Unicorns of Love.
Are possible. We have the combo after all. Just be aware that the disengage is pretty strong. We will probably play here on Rengar level 6.
It's gonna be she gets really the stronger team fights are not but so strong.
Remember what we did last game, because you guys did that really well.
And every member of H2K is popping off.
2 for 2, and H2K are running for their lives. To Unicorns, good response.
Ladies and gentlemen, here we go. H2K on the blue side, Unicorns of Love on the red. The two top teams coming in from Group B. They're looking for a playoff bye. They're looking to dominate this matchup, and they've already got their
queso?
Sights set
queso?
Ahead.
Queso? They're cheesing here. The Unicorns go in. Did anybody spot this?
Febvin.
Pings come out. There's blue pings everywhere. I think they saw the portal.
The ward
this
goes
is
down.
Horrible, by the way. Starting portal on Bard is useless.
No.
Because even level 2, after you just survive, like, you walk the lane with no spell, only an auto attack. You get one empowered hip slap, that's it. And then,
I mean, but Krepo, it's not like Karma's level 1 is really strong or
exactly,
anything.
Exactly, right? So you get hit in the face over and over and over, and then on level 2, you kind of want to take the health packs, because like, you're like, medic, somebody help me! And then you still don't have your stun. So if Karma and Ashe, Nuclear and Jay played as well, they could butcher this lane.
It's weird, because we're like, Hillisang, you're not going to take the hook, because you don't want to risk it on that montage moment. And I feel like he's still kind of risked it on that montage moment, because we know that would have been a highlight.
I mean, this is a really high payoff play, if it works, of course. He's collecting chimes right now, he's trying to get to level 2 as soon as he can. Usually you actually leave them in the jungle, because while you level up at 5 chimes, it's so worth to have them in your jungle so you can just use all your mana in lane, go pick them up, and then help to sustain.
Yeah, pretty much infinite health and mana sustain.
Here we go, Poke Wars. Like, Jay doesn't even care about the push. They need to be careful, though, here on the side of H2K if they can actually get shoved in. Jay's first Q was solely on the champion. That's why the Q went on the range creeps right here. Small push lead router for Unicorns, but the next Mantra will come up. Which means right here, the punish will come in.
Yep. Samix, yeah, pinned against the wall. No Mantra, but still good damage.
And now they just need to deny. They're going to let the wave settle and actually not fast push. Maybe get a small lead on creeps here, a couple hits. But right now, H2K should stop pushing and just look to walk up and deny.
Well, we're going to see how they adapt. But this was kind of the one strong lane for H2K. Yeah. The rest of the lane's super strong in the early game. But Caitlyn and Bard just not going to be able to outpush here. Yeah, as you said.
Hillisang's trying to draw creep aggro by getting all attacks from Shay. So his creeps turn around and hit Shay instead. There was a small overpush from H2K, which actually facilitate the Unicorn bot lane farming under tower right now. But even though H2K like slightly misplayed the push, look at the punish they're putting out on the Unicorns above bot lane. Because Hillisang has no trading tools whatsoever.
Now, H2K pushing in, continuing to control the dominance. They've got Jankos on that side of the map as well. you can see Jankos on the gray is pretty comfortable to push in, but down in levels compared to Xerxes so far.
Yep.
Taking a little bit of harass here, but Hillisang just spotting him out, letting him know where the junglers are.
Yeah, Xerxes started with the Korean clear, full clear on top side, but then he predicted Jankos' invade. It's pretty textbook. Pushing lanes very often lean on that side and have their jungler come in for the invade. Xerxes actually has a really good map read here, and Unicorns, they're playing around HDK's strengths very well in the early game.
Now he's set up to kind of control the top side as well, which has been a huge strong point for the Unicorns of Love, and setting Chachi up for success here as well.
Now look at these guys, man. These are the two best top laners in the league facing off against each other in what is actually a volatile matchup. So I'm really glad we see Camille versus Renekton here and not just a Nautilus matchup. One thing we have to point out, we see damage rating in the bottom on the screen. It basically is a metric that compares the average damage people do on a champion versus the way Vizichachi and Oduwamne respectively play it. So if you give, for example, Camille to Oduwamne, he's expected to get 16.8% more damage out of the champion compared to the average. So these guys consistently do more damage with the same champions as other players. That's why they're so good top laners.
Yeah, this is measured across wins and losses. Yeah. It's compared to LCK and NA as well as EU. So you have a huge sample size here, and these guys are still just doing so well compared to the rest of the teams in the league. And I mean, you gotta wonder, one gank goes wrong, carry potential from either of these guys on these champions can just blow this game wide open.
Yeah, Xerxes has switched this side control to the bottom side of the map right now. Samux looking to survive. These guys CS very well in lane. Hillisang and Samux have one of the best CSDs at 10 minutes as a bot lane. We're gonna see how they survive now with the lane deficit early on, and this is a good trade from Vizichachi.
Oduwamne taking a little bit of damage. Tax sweep gets health back, but still losing out very hard there.
And this is one of the reasons Renekton came to be a meta pick, because people needed an answer versus Camille, especially in the era when it was always Camille, LeBlanc, Rengar on purple side. They needed an answer. They say, like, we can't keep doing this over and over.
When you think about it too, I mean, you look at Tactical Sweep, you look at Cole the Meek, right? Two very similar skills in what they do, but Renekton just gets to leap into the wave, heal up any damage you do to him. I hate when this champion's in meta, because it gets picked in solo queue and no one ever survives their lane against a Renekton.
Yeah, double control ward here being revealed by Xerxes. He finds one. See if Jankos wants to contest rather the second one. If that's been communicated, that's one's been placed. Xerxes is going to peace out.
Still spotted out though, so that knowledge not going to be put to use quite yet, but Unicorns of Love, they are hitting that level 6 point soon, and that level 6 Rengar kind of has to be the center of our attention to see what he does. Evan.
And little fun story about Febben. He was on the analyst test the other day, and previous to his arrival, we had Exile, and we asked Exile who's the best mid laner in Europe, and he went Perks. It's like Perks over Febben, definitely. And we asked him why, because Perks is just a better player. And I'm not going to say Febben was triggered by that statement. He was just a little shaken up. So now he really wants to prove himself versus Exile, and they're doing so in quite the skill matchup here. Especially with the delay on distortion, it's much easier for LeBlanc to get charmed by an Ahri in lane.
Jankos is here to back him up, though. Next time, maybe looking for the 1v1. HDK not looking to give it to him.
Oh, he's this clone. Super smart. Because he went back for kind of the second wave of poke right there. Exile always dashing out instead of in. Now he's under pressure by Jankos. Sidestep. Good move.
Jankos maybe just trying to pressure out the lane here. Definitely wasn't going to come out on top in the trade, but it is still damage down onto Exile.
I really like that usage of the clone here. Really smart. LeBlanc play, absorbing the charm right there.
We did say this champion's going to be nerfed. We don't expect it to be quite the powerhouse that it once was, but clearly the mechanical skill is still very important in this matchup.
Yeah, that's mostly a reading from pro player predictions, but if you've ever listened to a Doublelift interview, you know they can also be wrong.
Ooh. 50-50 down the middle.
Yeah. 51. There we go. HDK1, it's over. Back it up, boys. We're going home. This one guy in the crowd is furiously texting on his phone right now. Hashtag UOLwin. Hashtag UOLwin.
Look at this is the time, folks. Just make 8 Twitter accounts.
Yeah.
The end, though. I mean, these are two very strong teams, and we've got a lot of games that we kind of expect to be one-sided, but I honestly have no idea what to expect from this one, although this is
Chachi.
Not quite so comfortable. He's going to get burned down here for sure. No chance to Cole the Meek again. No chance to heal up. First blood drops for H2K.
I really like that movement there. Going through the blast cone as the Jankos jumps over. Oduwamne immediately locks up Vizichachi. He cannot dash, flash, or get out in any way, shape, or form. And obviously, unless he kills Oduwamne, he's locked in there. And then Jankos has so much damage. I really like this combination. Any CC laner or jungler combined with the other guy having tons of damage is really good setup for top lane.
And I like the way Oduwamne is itemized as well. Gets the cloth armor, gets another Doran's, knows that he just wants to win out on the early game. And I mean, it pays off right there. The team playing very well around that snowbally topside.
It's obviously the League of Ninja Tobbies. That's where it's the cloth armor is going into later. And Yankos, he arrives. Vizuchachi wants to get out. Unless he flashes right on that spot, Orobamla will just chase, get the ulti off. Super easy gank.
Oh, just such a tough spot to be. You can see Odawamne pretty close to death there, but Renekton so reliant on those spells to output damage once he blows the combo. Just not a whole lot left for him to get.
Yeah, Xerxes has been doing a good job, though. Stole away the enemy red buff right there. So I think rest. Oh, Febben. On a control ward.
Double snare.
That's a huge opportunity miss right there for H2K. That could have been a one-shot kill.
And that's exactly what they need right now, because despite the kill going in their favor on the top side, gold's still very much in the favor of Unicorn's Love. And yeah, Camille got the assist, but 54-78 in CS. I'm sure Chachi still got the gold advantage here.
Yeah, and those are also plays right there that we saw in a mid lane that could influence a player's kind of a mental state. Missing a free ability like that charm is going to upset you, because this guy, Febben obviously respected Exile enough to maybe do the fake juke as he walked to the brush, you know? To expect Febben being there, but he just walked straight in. He didn't carry it. I had no clue Febben was in that brush.
It's the next level of mind game.
Yeah. Mithy, in better days, used to tell me how he would dodge hooks and skill shots. He would basically click in a direction and just get his hands off his mouse so he could no longer influence the direction, so the enemy had no clue if he could ever juke or not. You know, the guy would just walk straight, pick an angle and walk.
That's the classic strategy. That's the you don't know what I'm doing if I don't know what I'm doing.
Just clicked on a random button. You know, saying finally find that control ward. It's been there for ages. HTK's river control is dwindling right now, so Che, he will need backup if he wants to get that vision back, because right now Hillsang's level 6, Tempered Fate, very easy pick off.
And Hillsang, you know, this is kind of a champion we expect a lot of playmaking from. I like that you were talking about Thresh, because that feels like a Hillsang champion. I mean, Bard, Morgana in the same kind of wheelhouse. Don't think we'll see Morgana again, but the Bard, potential to find an engage here.
Yeah, hoping to just get that flash out of Nuka, right? Yeah.
Gets it.
Every time. It's free. And these guys, man, they get punished so hard, but the losing matchup, starting Magical Journey. Look at the CS. There's a CS lead on Samux. Like, this is not supposed to happen. These guys are really strong in lane as a duo.
And I mean, there has been some criticism for Samix. Yeah, he can't always go toe-to-toe when it comes to individual plays against some of the other top AD carries, but this man lanes like a god. However, Odawamne got a hookshot, wall dive out. Now locked up. Chachi's still walking forward, but Yankos has so much damage they can't afford to chase this. Chachi now going forward, but he's going to get locked up. There's nowhere he can go. He's not under the tower, however. Can he turn this? He needs just a little bit more damage. Odawamne flash out. Chachi gets one. He wants to turn it back. He's going to get the double. No. Febben is here. They're going to shut him down, but that is so close.
Yeah, you can really see the power of Renekton right there. Febben almost jumped over the wall to go for the pickups. He wanted the scraps right there, but Yankos, he was yelling for help right there because they found out that if you get him low, ooh. Yankos! No! That's greedy!
You can't disrespect the man in the mid lane. Exile's not taking it. And Febben, he wants a little blood back.
Yeah, Xerxes here too, but there's actually no follow-up damage here. And there's no ulti on Febben. They didn't want to go for the risky plays. Unicorns showing restraint here, getting a net win.
Good play. I mean, just beautiful mechanical plays from both sides, but...
Yeah, wow. Ooh, he still gets hit by the Q, trying to sidestep here. Now Vizuchachi goes for the turn. Yeah, slice and dice. Ultimate comes out. That is so destructive. The AoE from that ultimate. And just kind of the rage gain that you get. It's so hard for Yankos, who's now out of mana, has to flash out as well. And
Dominus, the auto, the Tiamat proc, the empowered Cold Amik for healing. It's so close to just turning against H2K.
Why is Yankos? Yankos wants an experience. He's like, give me that exile. Oh, you can get some experience. I really like that combo. W into flash. Much faster travel time on the flash, obviously. And then the good old jump back. Well played by Exile.
Breaks the distance, shuts him down. Now Hillsang's got the ultimate again, and they know there's no flash from Nuclear. Can't see if they got spotted in the bush, but they have to play smart here. Mm-hmm.
They can't do the traditional play where you want to go Magical Journey over that little wall, but if the Graves is waiting for you, you will get screwed. Hillsang, he's trying checking it. So if you use W on Bard, you get a brief moment of vision. And obviously, if you place it on the location, you can always see if there's a control ward or not, or if somebody's hiding in the brush.
Well, vision's important. I do want to shift our attention to the mid lane, because that's a proto bout LeBlanc Crepo, and I'm going to be honest, I don't know how to feel about that.
I mean, it's all about assassination, getting close and just getting the raw damage out. It's a decent item on the first spike. Obviously, later on, it doesn't scale that well.
And of course, the percentage scaling per bolt went down a long time ago. Still a very powerful item, not quite as gross as it was on release. Exile blocks the charm again. Now gonna hop back, throw the belt to safety. Febben's still running forward. In comes Xerxes. Is he gonna commit to this dive? Exhaust drops from Shay. Xerxes may be the man in trouble. Nope, cleanses it out. He's gonna walk away.
Exhaust still useful. Oh, he's going for the tower setup into nuclear, into trap, into Q.
Chain CC, but Samix is now the one locked up. Hillisang just tanking the tower for him. Continues to dish out damage. Flash back in, exhaust, all from the Kaylin. Oh, not quite enough.
Poorly executed dive from the Unicorns because they were scared of the teleport, but Chachi, he was close enough to all around it to stop them. So there was a brief window of hesitation here. But that play still nets the Unicorns teleport advantage. We need to see what they can do. They're already pushing bot lane. Next Tempered Fate will be up roughly in a minute, and then Viz Chachi can actually teleport down. That is the play the Unicorns are looking to set up right now.
Yeah, no heal. Flash may be up for nuclear. Not a whole ton of time left, but if he doesn't have it, you know they're going to lock him down. Can't be too bad for him at this stage. 71 seconds away, so Tempered Fate should come up first.
Yeah.
Okay, maybe we need to shift more resources to the bottom lane, but the top lane's been so rough for them already. I don't know if they can afford to.
And they just have a really good setup, you know, with Odoano's ultimate and a high damage graze right here. They're looking to repeat the same play they did earlier, but they're not quite sure about where Xerxes is, and obviously Vizichachi is playing with much more respect once the wave hits the turret.
And this is, when we look at it, not quite the game we may have expected initially. Unicorns of Love, we said they have the early game composition. They're executing it so well. They're starting to build early game leads. And for H2K, kind of surprising recently to see them not have a massive lead in this early game.
Yeah, they've been playing well, but their ramp-up time really is post 20 minutes, though. If you look at the gold graphs, especially later on, Hillisang now in trouble. Magical Journey will help him. What you really have to see is that at the start of season, it went up and down for H2K, but ever since cross-group play, and especially after IEM, they had some really good progression, especially in the mid to late game. They have the highest gold lead at 25 minutes out of any team. I think it's something like 3,800 gold. It's honestly very, very high.
Doing so well to improve, I mean, adapting a lot. Other thing that we wanted to know was kind of team fighting from this team. We haven't seen that proven against Unicorns yet, but that is going to be a big factor as we move later in the game.
Yeah, but both teams are just playing skirmish and pickoff, though. And that's what we need to see. Is Unicorns of Love going to fall in that same trap where they all hide in the bushes next to mid lane? Are we going to see better vision? Because I think Che and Jankos have actually been doing a great job getting vision together, and Xerxes and Hillisang need a bit more work in that department.
Well, right now, Hillisang and Samix still bullied out under the tower.
I mean, look at the vision. Triple deep ward. Unicorns, they don't know if this is coming. They can expect it, but even then, they're stuck under this turret.
Hillisang?
He's face-checking. Face-checking for vision. Whoa. Right there, he could have died.
All right, good job, Observers. Definitely trolled me. I thought he was dead 100% there.
And that's the point we're making here. H2K almost expected them to have some vision somewhere. I don't think they are actually aware of just how big their advantage is in terms of vision.
I mean, we look at it. There's two control wards on the map. One green ward, two, maybe now three as they get placed, but so little. Whereas H2K own the bottom side of that map. They have lit up everything, and that's really risky play. Coming against Ahri, this champion who can roam. Coming
against
the
But there's one ward that they need right there. Che just passed it around the corner. You don't place it in the brush, you place it over the brush. And right now, Vizichachi could teleport down and they could look for Tempered Fate. That's why Jankos is obviously, yes, that one, Observers. Dramatic zoom on the ward.
Dun, dun, dun.
And Xerxes said, guess what they're trying to do here, guys? Exhaust coming too. I don't know, man. It almost looks like Unicorns are planning a party in the bot lane. The
H2K
members.
Unicorns do love parties.
Yeah.
H2K, they don't want to attend this party, however. They're just going to back off.
They're waiting for their invite.
It's a little rude, Unicorns of Love. I mean, you don't throw a party at someone else's house and then not invite them, Crepo. I feel like that's rude.
They come in for the cake, they eat it, and then they leave. Take down the first turret. Unicorns with the bonus gold, now 1,500 gold in the lead. But H2K, they have managed to play around the teleport disadvantage without losing any kills, at least.
1.5k, this is a good start from Unicorns. This is the early game we talked about, but is it enough to kind of match the scaling that H2K have put together as we move later in the game?
Yeah, Unicorns, they just opted in very heavy. It's not like H2K's comp scales super well, in my opinion. It's just that Unicorns' comp doesn't scale at all. They have very early game oriented picks. They're obviously playing versus Exhaust and Che as well, so it's very easy to shut down burst mages, because while Exhaust got nerfed, guys, it's still really good versus the likes of LeBlanc. If you can buffer it, find her as she's flanking, if you have that vision, you just pre-click it. And when she jumps in, all her combo gets exhausted, and that's not enough.
The classic, the most frustrating spell to play against. We all cheered when Exhaust, well, not all of us. AD carries cried when Exhaust got nerfed.
I mean, some of them did. Hillisang is taking a lot of liberties moving around the map. This is the type of play that gets him punished very often.
Doesn't get him punished there, and we did say we wanted to see more vision coming down from Unicorns of Love.
The difference is that when Jankos and Che do it, they kind of move together, or they're 100% sure of where the opponent is. I mean, Hillisang is just making very accurate guesses in this game so far.
He's just on another level, Crepo. Doesn't even need the
minimap. He may very well be. There is a way to deduce information in terms of back timings that you can safely face take rushes, but it's quite hard.
Devin locked up. Snare does land. Hill saying not going to throw any out any follow up.
It's so hard because Fever can always flash or dash out. And at this point, they really need to make that ulti stick.
The vote has now shifted.
That guy, man.
This is election night updates.
Nuclear.
Oh.
Flashes out. Zergs should have him.
Oh. Goes in. Is locked up for a few more seconds. Can Che get there in time? Heal. Makes it out to safety. Not at all what Unicorns of Love wanted. Nice escape in the end.
Yeah, Halo's son trying to lock him down. Buys more time. Che was in time with the reactionary play there. Could have been executed slightly better, and you can see Unicorns of Love haven't really practiced this Bard Rengar combo too much and aren't communicating that well.
Unfortunate. May have been able to get it without that. Oh, Oduwamne now
nice
caught out though. Flash out. As Itachi goes forward, he wants a little bit more. Oduwamne, what are you going to do? Does use the shield, uses the parry, but it's not enough. Invulnerability on the alt, not going to save him from the constant damage Renekt is dishing out. Unicorns of Love grabbing a dragon as well.
Yeah, Chase Nuclear survives, but Unicorns of Love still get a win on both the top side with the kill by Itachi, and they get a win on the bot side with that dragon here. They're on complete control of this early game.
And it's so crazy. We see, you know, first blood dropping for H2K. We see first up for Unicorns of Love, rather, and they're just making plays across the map. They're dominating here.
Yeah, that's really good movement from Vizicacci. He knows at the corner there, he's always going to have his body overlay with that one of Oduwamne's, and he just simply can't get out. And this is obviously the reason Renekton, we talked about it before, became a meta pick, because he's really strong into the Camille, and the early flex is actually being punished here.
So solid for this team. And we see H2K. I mean, 80% dragon control rate coming into this game, and Unicorns of Love are the ones just controlling the early game now. This is unprecedented.
Yeah, it's absolutely absurd. If you look at H2K's dragons conceded per game that they have played, they were in the best spot. They were in the first spot, and the team that was second conceded twice as many dragons.
Yeah,
and then it went all the way down.
Team give away less than one dragon on average per game.
Yeah, they
G2,
like,
who's second, give away double that. I
yeah,
believe?
0.7 is what Ooh. They give away. Now Exile's in trouble. And now he will likely safe. Drop because Fevim can't chase here. He needs to get the Blast Cone.
Use. Blast Cone, yeah, definitely going to be safe there. Now comes Xerxes. Yes, Fevim overstays his welcome. Flash to the wall, but it's Hillisang and the Baron as well. Just trying to dish out the damage. Fevim, one shot going to connect onto Hillisang. He's actually going to go down. Baron turns against him. Now the fight has gone crazy. Xerxes goes in. Arrow locks him up. Chachi wants to do something, but there's too many members. Trying to heal up just a little bit, leaps into the backline, wants to get a little bit more. Where's the Cole, the Meek? Charm stops him for just a moment, but Exile's still here. Samix is going off! Unicorns! They crush the fight!
Vizicacci's Renekton bought so much time in the front line. He really sucked up the damage. And now finally, we see what we've been waiting for from Samix. Aggressive performance in teamfights. Very often was he afraid of skill shots and kind of backpedaling in the fights. He went for the aggressive flash and he finished off three members in total, I believe. No, two. Two kills on the board right there. Super well played teamfight here and skirmish by the Unicorns.
The whole team just opens up space for Samix to work. They say, here, you want to shoot people? We'll give you the time. We'll give you everything you need.
Yeah, we were talking about these dragons before this replay, and Unicorns overall are just bucking a lot of trends for H2K. H2K are on the offensive on this play. Look, Fevivin goes, but Exile is buying so much time. Respect Flash, Dash, uses the Blast Cone. He completely neutralizes Fevivin, who's now also out of the fight because he overextends. And this is something we have seen from H2K in the past, where they overcommit on a call. But it looks so good. At this point, H2K can disengage, but they get baited into the fight looking so good. Just look at Vizicacci. This is a 2v4, by the way, that the Unicorns are winning, and eventually Exile gets the Honey Fruit and he jumps back in. But this flash from Samix is absolutely beautiful to watch. All the eyes were on Vizicacci. He single-handedly carried a 2v4 right there.
And you look at that, too. That's got to be the worst spot to be as Fevivin. Maybe the worst spot to be for Oduwamne. Gets a little bit of damage mitigated by using the ultimate there, trying to run to safety. He's going to drop, and Unicorns Love, they're just going to pick up another kill here, making it look effortless. Now the 1v1 on the bottom side. Cold the Meat goes in. Fevivin's running for his life.
Yeah, Fevivin trades three dashes for two here. Vizicacci is such a beast on this Renekton. Really putting the team on his back right here with the pressure. And all that deep vision we talked about earlier, Dracos, it's fallen completely apart for H2K, and they can't actually move deep enough anymore without dying.
Yeah, now that the laning phase is over, they have no guarantee that anyone is where they expect them to be. Things going south very quickly. Nuclear is still taking a ton of damage, and I just want to look at the top lane CS. 165 to 237. Vizicacci is crushing this game.
Yeah, and they're just going to start Baron here because they have four traps set up. They have an Exile LeBlanc lurking in the shadows right here, really keeping people away. A Blue Drink is needed to spot it, but even then, even with the knowledge that Unicorns of Love are doing Baron right now, I do not think H2K can do anything.
A little bit of poke goes down on the Yankos. H2K too busy clearing out the wards. And yeah, Unicorns of Love are growing low, but no one else there to fight them. They're just taking on the raid boss. Exile may be in trouble. Traps there to take him safe. Baron drops.
Super clean game by the Unicorns. And we talked about the trends. They're playing against a team in H2K that single-handedly, like, super easily swept away the Misfits. 2-0. This is a team that has been trending upwards ever since cross-group play. They had the largest leads at 25. They barely get behind. I think 18 out of 21 games or something, the HJK had a lead at 15 minutes. Like, they're so strong in this early to mid-game, and Unicorns, they come in and say, oh, no, I don't care about your stats. We're going to draft early. We're going to smack you in the face a couple of times. Exo's going to roll. And then, obviously, the hashtags come out.
Yeah, apparently the 50% win for HJK, that's fake news, Krepo.
Fake news. Lies.
Unicorns of love. Now looking to catch Che out. Have the guaranteed stun follow-up. Not going to throw it out. Ooh, are going to get two.
Sexy binding. That makes me happy.
That skill is so hard to play against.
Because you need to rely on how your teammates are dodging. And all pro players dodge in the same way, so if you hit one, you're going to hit two.
So clean. But right now, it's Exile split pushing.
Yeah.
It's Renekton on the bottom side. Maybe Xerxes going to be the one to get caught out, though.
Ups the ulti, wants to rotate. Unicorns are playing on three lanes, and this is something they did very early. And quite well, actually. They've definitely been developing their 1-3-1.
It's interesting, too, because this is what we saw from Exile right when he first joined the team. It was the LeBlanc, it was the pushing in the side lanes. But let me tell you, there's a lot more deaths in that column.
He definitely has refined himself as a player here, and he makes a statement against Febben as well. Picking this LeBlanc, so many players are talking about how this champion is ruined. This champion doesn't see any play anymore. It's useless. Well, he picked it into Ahri, pressured the matchup, and he's definitely having a large influence on the map.
Yeah, has the Lich Bane. As the Merc Trez looks like he's going toward the Void Staff as well, the Proto Belt. This man does a lot of damage. Has to be careful, though.
Yeah. We still need to look at Samix, though, because his comrades are falling off. Caitlyn on a two-item spike is okay. Three items, not the best versus other AD carries. The four-item Caitlyn is where it starts counting, really. That is Unicorns of Love's late-game insurance. But then he needs to step up.
Yeah, but so often the late game for Unicorns is also backed up by an Ivern or a Shen. This time it's Samix against the world. There's not those supporting picks that they usually have. But they're so far ahead, it might just not matter.
Yeah, definitely. Right now they're very comfortable. They pick up an extra Infernal, more late game insurance, and they're playing an early game comp like you have to. You have to snowball, get ahead. They're making picks, Tempered Fate. They're not getting punished by HJK for a lot of their face checks in the early game. And honestly, I think they demand too much respect in HJK. Gave a bit too much respect over to the Unicorns.
The EU LCS stats team has just checked in. This is the worst deficit H2K have ever had in 25 minutes. We
not
talked
surprised.
About earlier, this is where we expected them to turn it on, and it's just falling apart. Well, fight goes forward. Charm goes on to Hillisang, but there's no follow-up there. Tempered Fate, not going to connect.
Just to scare him. This is what I could do to you. Next one's going to hit.
Watch out for the spooky eyes.
No wave clear from Exile.
But Wamne goes in, they're trying to shut down Samix. They know this is the scaling option. Heal comes out, decent damage. That's one taken down with the TP's coming in. Renekton's on his way. Moto Wamne just gonna burn down to the Ignite. Hillisang flashes forward, not gonna connect.
Yeah, so. Pretty rash play here from the Unicorns. Visichachi came in with Teleport. Moto Wamne obviously has his up if they can stall. And this is the first kind of failed move, failed attempt by the Unicorns, where they overcommit. They're not on the same page. They didn't connect their skill shots when necessary.
But Visichachi is still going to get something out of it because they are so far ahead because they had that bot lane in their favor.
And that's the beauty of a goalie that is as large as Unicorns. It was 9,000. It's now over 10,000. When you play the early game that well, there's only decent plays and good plays you can make. This is not a great play, but in map-wise, it's actually a decent play because they still get the bot lane turret.
In an even game, that's called getting caught. When you're this far ahead,
that's
called baiting, creating space. That one's special.
Absorbing pressure, too.
Oh, absorbing pressure. Creating space is my favorite.
Yep. Who was it? Steak? Steak was really good at absorbing pressure. This guy just got ganked. Didn't really kill anybody, but boy, did he absorb pressure.
So much pressure. Monumental levels of pressure.
Do you like to absorb pressure in your games?
Is that what we call me losing every lane I ever play? Yes. Absorb a lot of pressure.
I'm just making sure we see the jungler.
I lose in a 2v2 Krepo. There's no saving me. It's not
there's
even
jungler.
I just all in all the time. It's grim.
Hillisang, Xerxes looking for Tempered Fate combo.
Could be grim for Jankos.
The map is tiny right now, though. This is where Pickums have a lot of a harder time closing because they need a Baron buff, essentially, to make 1-3-1 efficient. If H2K turtle up, it's much harder for Unicorns to find that one guy that's overextended, to find him alone.
And it's really rough for H2K too, because when we want to look for weaknesses on H2K, sometimes it's late game decision making, but for Samix, it's his decision making right now. Hillisang can't save the
and
day.
And that is the complexity of playing 1-3-1 without sufficient vision. You need to tread carefully, or you will overstep.
Unicorn's Love still fine, still in control. Baron 2 minutes away. Ocean Drake next up. But can't afford to keep getting picked off like this. There, so much of the pressure has been mitigated because of the missteps from Samix.
Yeah, and they're eliminating the vision. That's most important for Unicorns. They don't care if they drop a member here or there, as long as they keep the vision control. Because just like you said, a minute and 30 seconds, that's what we're waiting for, the next Baron spawn. If there is complete Fog of War control again for the Unicorns, it will look grim for H2K. They will need to use their one and single Hawkshot right there to get the vision and make it move somehow.
Only the one blue trinket as well, so just not a whole ton of tools to spot this out when they're on the back foot. So desperate to just keep control of their own base that they're not even considering that they might need those trinkets in the future.
Yeah, and with Feathervan itemizing slightly defensively, look at him. Merc Threads and Negatron Cloak, he only has 2 damage items, which means the remaining members of Unicorns of Love can actually invest in Ninja Tabis. Like, Visichachi and Xerxes will be incredibly tanky in these fights because they're almost exclusively fighting attack damage based champions. And it's so good to get Tabis versus them.
Yeah, I mean, you look at it, Camille, so much of that damage. Auto attacks, Graves.
Yeah, right, auto attacks.
Graves, Ash,
auto attacks.
Look at that. Not even a Lich Bane from Mario. Odawamne, though, he's definitely caught out.
Auto attacks.
Auto attacks.
His Ninja Tabi did not save him. H2K have 5 control wards in their inventories. They're ready to play the vision game, but Unicorns of Love are not allowing it whatsoever.
Choking him out at every point, looking for every opportunity to shut them down. Now Visichachi's on the bottom tower, and H2K, they're going to have to respond, but Samix is in the mid lane already.
Yeah, Samix has a defensive barrier put up with the traps. All he needs to do is just flash over them if he ever gets threatened. This is a 4v5 with Unicorns with over 10,000 gold lead. This should be at least some hits on the base or a rotation towards Nashor.
H2K just holding on for dear life in this game. Members committed just to clear waves.
But just look at the vision. If you would toggle H2K's vision, they see absolutely nothing. They see Exile right now, they see Healsign, but they have no clue what's going on. Are they doing Nashor already? They don't know. They just found out they are. So this is aggressive peeling from the Unicorns.
Hawkshot spots him out. This is bad news for H2K. 2 members getting locked up, but Exile and Healsign, they're just buying time.
It has to be at like 2k.
Lower.
Yeah, like it should be done pretty soon right now. It's too hard for H2K to do anything.
Nothing they can do. Tempered Fate. Exile maybe can look for follow-up, blocks up Nuclear. Che on the front line still. Unicorns of Love, they get the Baron. They're just going to look to keep the push going. Healsign, though, maybe looking to start a fight. That's not what you want to do! Don't take the journey! Oh, but Chachi's still alive. He's still dishing out the damage, but now he's locked up. Samix, it's all on you. Can you save the day? Unicorns of Love, have you thrown the game away? And yes, H2K, they're going to pick it right back up.
When somebody offers you a magical journey that looks too good to take, at least consider for a moment if you really want to go on that trip. Definitely not a great idea for Unicorns. What a throw, and this could actually be an opening here for H2K.
Odawamne, he chases down Xerxes. H2K now pushing up. Now Unicorns of Love, they have that big lead, but H2K, they're going to start to claw back.
First tower for H2K at 31 minutes in the game. A gift by Healsign.
It's been a magical journey for H2K, that's for sure.
Sometimes, man, you start with a small portal, that's the problem, you know? And then you get... The walls get bigger and bigger, and you're like, okay, I can make this. Oh, I can outflank them. And then you realize your team is going in by one. This is like the conga line of destruction. Strike this. This is okay. It's fine. Exile's half HP. I love the commitment, though. Let's go. 1, 2, 3. Samix is like, guys, is this a great idea? I'm helping. I'm coming.
It's like, guys, the Renekton was supposed to go first. Like, oh, yeah, okay, that makes sense. That makes a lot more sense.
We talked about the queuing order. And then really good E flashy from Fevin, instant Captain Jack QSS, and...
just up to this moment, it was so good, Crepo!
Yeah.
It was beautiful macro play, they got the Baron, they choked H2K out, and then it went a little sideways.
They had room for failure. They built up some credit. And now we're at 8,000 gold. Actually, I love the fact that he made that play, because now the series gets a lot more interesting. And H2K have a way to fight back, because remember, gold lead doesn't mean everything when there is a scaling difference. And more importantly, this comp needs Nashor to close the base. And Nashor is already running out. It's only on Xerxes.
All around the Rengar to try to force the push forward.
Ooh. This actually means we're probably going to stall until next Baron. And by that point, there should be like an extra item or so on H2K. I think they may just yield the Elder here as well.
Yeah, but there's a lot of defensive items coming in from H2K. You mentioned it earlier for Fepavin's build. He's now opted for the Void Staff, not the Abyssal Scepter, but still so little damage in the kit right now. So few damage focus, or for so few items focused on pure damage. Really needs to be able to pop any member of Unicorns of Love quickly.
Yeah, this is what Odawamne is trying to do every time. He moves with the team, and he wants to find somebody alone from the Unicorns, put him in the cage, and beat him up. Then he has to deal with Visichachi.
That's scary. You don't want to put Visichachi in the
cage. Oh, definitely don't want a cage fight with him. Bard looking for Tempered Fate here.
And a Quadra Love. They're just trying to brute force. It's going to work now. Odawame. Wall dives to safety.
Gotta let Visichachi lead the conga. Very important. This man has rhythm.
He knows how to do it. Nope. Just follow his lead. All right, let's follow the trend here. In goes Visichachi. Out goes Visichachi. Out goes the Unicorns of Love.
Yep. They have, they're setting up the, like, the Mighty V with the traps. I'm liking it.
Yeah. Let's see if they can do a little bit more. Arrow's going to miss. Exile hops over the wall. Things look good. That's an inhibitor down. It's slow. It's steady. Maybe it's not what we always expect from the Unicorns of Love, but they're making it work.
It's clean, and that's what they need to do.
Odo, that was brave.
He was trying to pick them off. His team wasn't supported. Much closer here. Right now, Yankos puts the poke here on Hillsang. Good portal.
That's one you definitely want to take.
I think Ishikei's going to commit right here, honestly, because they're now going to wait for Visichachi to push in. But they missed the charm, so that's at least 6 seconds. Odo's going
to
go in.
Wants to get something, walks up Exile. He cannot hop to safety. Little Blanc is trapped. The little Blanc is taken down, but the TP's coming in from Visichachi. He leaps in on the nuclear, quickly exhausted, but Cersei's on the back line. Visichachi is still alive. In comes Hillsang. In comes Samix. Cersei, the only one left. Now backing off.
Yeah, great timing from HK. If they did not commit on that single second right there, they would have just straight up lost the game because his inhibitor would have fallen. They find Exile without any counterplay whatsoever, and then they peel Visichachi with the exhaust. Now Odawamne gets stuck on a corner.
Tactical sweep doesn't quite connect, doesn't quite slow down the Bard, but that's the beauty of this Camille pick, something we don't often get to appreciate, as it's usually just dominating on a side lane, but you want to shut down a LeBlanc.
Yeah,
there's no better ult.
Exile feels so safe here with the dashes, but obviously once you're stuck in the cage, you're not getting out. And I really like the timing on that engage. Because if they let Visichachi teleport channel, it's probably over. If Exile plays a little bit more safe, it's probably over for H2K. So they buy themselves another life.
And H2K, I mean, backs against the wall. Still almost a 10k advantage from Unicorns of Love. They've got the Mountain Drake, the Ocean Drake, the Infernal.
Do not get this wrong. Unicorns of Love are still very much so in the lead. They're solid to close this game. They have many ways they can do it. They can 1-3-1, 4-1. They can just 5-0 rush down a single lane. They can go for Elder. They can go for Baron Bait. The world is their oyster right now.
And we just got to say, I mean, once again, Visichachi in top lane weak. We couldn't have written it better ourselves.
Yeah.
I mean, just carrying the game here.
And Odawamne in top lane weak, he finds Exile. Look, no damage. This guy dashes into the wall twice, you know? Doesn't learn. Really good exhaust here. Everybody's peeling Visichachi, stepping backwards. They still get Odawamne's GA. And then they can't chase at all. They don't have the damage anymore on the side of H2K.
Yeah, it's just such a rough spot to be because Odawamne, he wants to leap to safety, but he has to hookshot wall dive into the Renekton to stop him from taking down more members of that team. But we said Unicorns of Love were going to be the team that resorted to camping and brushes. Now it's H2K.
And the tower fell really low, so they get the poke on Chachi. That's good, but this guy's just going to ulti up. More importantly, they need the wave dead. That is so important that that wave does not get access to the turret with the members of Unicorns of Love. If they just want to go in here, they can use the next wave to dash through, they can just instantly one-shot that turret. This is going to be a big explosive fight, I believe.
And between the Bard, the Cole, the Meek, the Elixir of Wrath that Visichachi has running, he just heals up all that poke damage. This could be it though, Krepo. This could be the final fight. H2K, can they hold on? Unicorns of Love, they're not taking the risk.
Yeah, very aggressive defense here from H2K. No more splitting by Unicorns either. But they're looking to start setting up the Nasha. Let's see at the wards. There's three of them, two left for Hillsang. Deep control ward, kind of wasted.
One blue trinket up, Ash, Hawkshot should be up and available as well. So H2K
so
can't
hard.
Get vision.
It's so hard if you're H2K right now. You're only just basing with Nuclear and Odawamne. They're giving away Nasher. Unicorns, they're hoping for a pick. Great job as well. Always push in mid first. Don't give them access to walk into the mid lane because those minions, they'll mess you up. And they don't know if H2K or if Unicorns right now have started the Nasher or not.
Exile just threatening, continuing to poke. Last time they saw this.
Yeah, that's the Hawkshot. That's what Unicorns were waiting for. H2K, they're pushing mid, they're doing the right thing. Chase stepping up, finds Visichachi, so they know they're actually not on the Nasher right now. This is good for H2K, but they need to run.
Looking for the flank. Tempered Fate, not going to connect anybody. Nice sidestep from Odawamne. But H2K, they're still not going to lead. They still need to play safe. Visichachi caught up, taking a lot of damage. Out comes the Hextech Ultimatum. They're looking to take him down. They do get him in the end. Cersei tries to go into the side. H2K, they're pulling back, but Cersei goes right back in to find a kill of his own. One for one so far. Unicorns of Love on the advance.
Yeah, on the advance. What a beautiful play from Odawamne. Not only does he sidestep Tempered Fate, he goes in on the right exact time to get Visichachi, trades his life for a super fed crocodile. And more importantly, they force Unicorns of Love out their major pick cooldowns. And right now, a pick comp without their major cooldowns isn't that strong. Yanks needs to be careful, though.
Oh, it's out of the wall. Chains connect. Not enough burst damage there to take him down.
And they're all pretty much making a phalanx around Nuclear. He has to carry these fights in the late game. Exile's looking for a cheeky push. I like this.
Oh, he's just buying time.
He should commit it. Unicorns are on the Nashor, though, while Exile's trying to split push.
Moving forward, they're forcing H2K back and forth. Where are they going to go? Are they going to defend the base? Are they going to contest the Nashor? What is left for H2K?
Yeah, I'm just waiting to see what Xerxes is doing with the ultimate. They're trying to buy time while those minions are ramming into the base.
Visachi
now has teleport. So this is going to be a decision. Visachi just teleport bot right now.
Oh, Unicorns tower just dropped.
If Unicorns disengage from the Nashor and Visachi teleports in the base, they can get three nips.
So pulling back as well. They're buying so much time. Four members committed here.
Chachi's teleporting.
Decent
They're going
damage.
For the fight.
Looking for the flank. Here comes that Crocodile. Leaps in, does get locked up, but Exile, he's trapped in the cage. Orowamne snared up for a brief moment, though, buying a bit of time, but Chachi's unstoppable. He leaps forward, but he can't kill Nuclear. He does take down Febby, but the AD carry remains alive as Unicorns Alive clean it up.
It doesn't matter. Four H2K members followed. Nuclear did his best sidestepping and kiting, but it just simply wasn't enough. The Unicorns have earned too much gold, too many items, too much power, and on top of all that, they pick up the Baron buff.
Ooh, they build a lead in the early game. It gets a little sketchy on one Baron pay, but they're starting to close out clean. Unicorns of Love come into this series swinging. They're going to get it. They're going to take the fight, and they're going to take game one. Little BM to cap it off, taking down members in the Nexus. GG, Unicorns of Love.
Yeah, early snowball composition really paid off, man. Pretty good to look at Exile, man. He picks the LeBlanc early. He leaves the counterpick open to Febben and then beats him. Straight up, just beats him in the lane. Out pressures. You have Visichachi. Despite getting ganked by Yankos for that first blood, still smashed that laning phase. And then bot.